a lot more comfortable requiring vaccination.
Economists say getting public health back to normal is ultimately good for business. Elise Preston, CBS News, New York.
New this morning, the future is looking bright for short-term rental owners and investors. Although COVID-19 cases are spiking across the country, the record amount of people are continuing to travel. According to rental management platform Guesty, reservations are up 122% compared to this time last year. Nightly rates have also jumped more than 30%. According to the report, Labor Day rental prices are higher than July 4th.
It's funny, I'm still old school. I still, if I'm going anywhere, I'm staying in a hotel. I haven't done B&Bs or any of that yet.
See, I'm doing a B&B this weekend.
We always stay in Airbnbs.
Really?
I mean, yeah, no, we haven't stayed in a hotel in probably, I mean, yeah, that's a lie. But like,
I'm older than you.
Yeah. I'll let you know how it goes this weekend. We'll see.
Yeah, but no, we definitely stay in more Airbnbs than hotels. It's just something unique every time instead of the same old hotel room, so.
Gotcha. Cool stuff out there.
I tell you what, I posted on Twitter yesterday that I needed a beach with the kind of heat that we're dealing with across the Miami Valley. And same story is true today. We're waking up so warm and muggy out there. It kind of feels like when you open up that, I guess, hotel balcony door, and you can feel that mugginess at the beach just stick to your face. We got that this morning, 77 degrees here in Dayton, 74 up towards Troy, 75 in Eaton. No 60s out there this morning, so not near as refreshing. And earlier this morning, we were even tracking a couple showers across Mercer and Auglaize counties. Those are now moving a little bit closer towards Lake Erie up there, and we're just dry in the Miami Valley. But as we get into the afternoon, that's when I think we could see that redevelopment out there. Traffic moving along smoothly. Luckily, we didn't see any rain closer to the Dayton area, so there's no wet roads or anything to slow you down out there. We're just left with partly to mostly cloudy skies, and as we talked about, the very warm temperatures. If you want to try to get outside and have some fun out of the Dark County Fairgrounds, that great Dark County Fair continues today. Temperatures, like yesterday, should rise pretty quickly. Already to 80 degrees by 10 in the morning, 87 by 2. Will likely top out around 90 to 91 degrees today before we fall off through the 80s. And rain chances are low, but you can't rule them out, as I do think we'll have a couple isolated showers with us this afternoon. Just got a brand new run of future cast in. You see we have the mostly cloudy skies through much of the morning hours this morning. And then as we get into the afternoon, here we go. Pop-up showers and thunderstorms. Finally, they're back in the forecast, and I think we'll see a better chance of rain today as compared to yesterday. So if you need some rain on your grass out there, I do think we'll have at least a 30% chance today. And also, the clouds and the showers that we'll have around this afternoon will provide us with some relief from the heat from time to time. By 5 p.m. this evening, still hanging on to a couple of those showers and isolated downpours, and then later tonight, I expect most of those to go to bed with the loss of daytime heating. Very similar forecast for Thursday, partly cloudy skies to start the day. Then as we get into the afternoon, a couple of those showers and thunderstorms start to bubble up yet again. And again, that'll give some of us a little bit of relief from the heat tomorrow afternoon. If you want to do some grilling tonight, you may run into one of those showers early. We'll call it a stray shower chance around 6 p.m. with temperatures right around 86 degrees. Very muggy, though, so if you are going to be outside, you'll probably feel yourself sweating just because the sweat isn't going to evaporate really easily off your skin to cool you off. So pretty warm and uncomfortable to start falling off through the 80s as we go through the course of the evening. All right, temperatures over the next couple days are not going to cool off very much. I have us at 90 or 91 right on through Sunday of this week. And keep in mind, we have that mugginess around as well, so the heat index is going to be even higher, feeling like 100 at times this afternoon, 99 tomorrow, a little bit, not more comfortable, but less unbearable as we get towards Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. Five-day forecast is hot, humid, and occasionally stormy. A little bit better chance of rain as we get towards Sunday, and then same story as we get towards Monday and Tuesday, but we're just stuck in a very stagnant, repetitive pattern through the week with isolated storm chances and temperatures right around 90 just about every day. Sergeant Mark Bauer keeping an eye on the roadways this morning, and Sarge, hopefully we're keeping the good commute rolling as we get later in the morning.
Been pretty quiet out here so far, Austin. Good road conditions, and anyone headed out to the freeway right now will be glad to hear that. We've also checked in with several area police departments. Everyone that we've talked to so far is reporting a quiet drive. This is what it looks like out on 675 southbound from 70 to Route 35. That's a 13-mile drive, and right now looking at the road sensors, and it's indicating a 12-minute drive time. I'm Sergeant Mark Bauer, WHIO Team Traffic.
522, 77 degrees. Three college athletic conferences are coming together.
the reason they're forming an alliance, and why this could be a big win for fans.
A new warning over processed meats, why some meats commonly found in charcuterie boards could make you sick.